بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Indeed, the praise is for Allah. We praise Him, we seek His help, and we seek His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evils that are within ourselves and from our bad deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides, no one can lead this person astray. And whomsoever Allah leads astray, then there is no guide for him. I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped except for Allah, who is alone with our partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the servant of Allah and his last messenger to all of mankind. O you who believe, fear Allah with the right that he should be feared, and do not die unless you are in a state of submission to Allah. As a Muslim practicing al-Islam, O mankind, fear your Lord, who has created you from a single person, and from that person created his mate, and from them two scattered countless men and women throughout the earth. And fear Allah, from whom you demand your mutual rights, and do not cut off the relations with the wombs that have bore you. Indeed, Allah is a watcher over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say that which is correct, in order that Allah may rectify for you your deeds and forgive you of your sins. And whomsoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has achieved a tremendous achievement. As to what follows, certainly the most truthful speech is the Book of Allah, the Quran, and the best guidance is the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the most evil of the affairs are the newly invented matters in the religion. And every newly invented matter in the religion is innovation, and every innovation is going astray, and every going astray is in the hellfire. From that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has criticized in the Quran from the blameworthy characteristics, a person being afraid and shy in front of the people, a person not wanting the people to know about his or her evil, but at the same time, the person is not afraid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions in Surah An-Nisa, verse 108, يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ النَّاسِ وَلَا يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ اللَّهِ. They seek to conceal and hide their evil deeds and their crimes from the people, but they don't seek to hide their evil and their crimes from Allah. وَهُوَ مَعْهُمْ إِذْ يُبَيِّتُونَ مَا لَا يَرْضَى مِنَ الْقَوْلِ. And He, Allah, is with them when they spend the night indulging in that which He is not pleased with from the speech. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطًا. And Allah is all encompassing of that which they do. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is reprimanding the hypocrites. He is reprimanding the criminals, those who are weak in faith, weak in their certainty, those who fear the people more than they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, He is reprimanding these individuals. As for the hypocrites, then we know their affair. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has exposed the hypocrites throughout the Quran. We have Surah Al-Munafiqun, the chapter of the hypocrites. In the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah, when Allah mentions the three categories of people, the believers, the disbelievers, and then the hypocrites. Most of the verses as it relates to the three categories of people were mentioning the hypocrites because of their evil and their danger, outwardly displaying faith, but in their hearts they disbelieve. The hypocrites are the people who seek to conceal their evil from the people, but when it relates to Allah, they don't have that shyness. They don't have that respect and reverence and awe for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But they don't want to be exposed to the people. And likewise, you have from amongst the criminals, those who are weak in faith, that they present a face to the people, a face of righteousness, a face of being dutiful to Allah and having strong iman, strong faith. But when they are alone, they don't seek to conceal their evil from Allah. And Allah Azza wa Jalla is all aware of that which is in the hearts of mankind. It is mentioned in some of the books of tafsir that there was an individual who stole a shield or some armor from a person. And the people, they went to complain to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about this affair, and that the individual had dug a hole in his home and buried the piece of armor or the shield under the ground so that no one can see it. So Allah Azza wa Jal, He revealed this verse, يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ النَّاسِ وَلَا يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ اللَّهِ. They seek to hide their crimes from the people, but they don't seek to hide their crimes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah, He knows and sees all things. We have a narration on the authority of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم استحيوا من الله حق الحياء. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he mentioned that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he mentioned, be shy as it relates to Allah with true shyness. Qulna ya Nabi Allah, lanastahyi walhamdulillah. The Sahaba, they respond, O Prophet of Allah, we have shyness, and the praise is for Allah. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس ذاك. That's not what I'm talking about. ثم قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ولكن الاستحياء من الله حق الحياء أن تحفظ الرأس وما وعى. He says, however, the true shyness from Allah is that you preserve your head and that which it comprehends. وَتَحْفَظْ الْبَطْنِ وَمَا حَوَىٰ, and that you preserve your belly and your insides and that which it takes in. وَتَتَذَكَّرْ الْمَوْتِ وَالْبِلَىٰ, and that you remember death and you remember the decaying of your body in the grave. وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةِ تترك زينة الدنيا وتترك زينة الدنيا ومن أراد الآخرة ترك زينة الدنيا. And whoever desires, whoever wants the hereafter, then let him abandon the delights and the beauties of this world. ثم قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ومن فعل ذلك فَقَدْ اسْتَحْيَىٰ, and whoever has done that, then this is the one who has truly observed shyness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد, we heard the words of our beloved Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم as it relates to the true meaning of shyness with Allah, that the person preserves his head in that which it comprehends. The scholars, they mentioned the head consists of your eyes, your tongue, and your ears. We must preserve our sight, our speech, and our hearing from that which is haram, out of shyness for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we must preserve and protect our thoughts from that which is inappropriate, out of shyness for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We must preserve our bellies and be mindful of that which we eat and drink, and be mindful we put into our bodies and make sure that it is from the halal. And some even mention that this also includes the heart, being that the heart is inside of the body, that a person must be mindful of that which is in his heart, out of shyness for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We must remember death and remember that we will be in the grave and our bodies will decay. So do not give precedence to pleasing your physical body over pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Out of shyness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if a person truly wants the hereafter, he truly wants to meet Allah upon goodness, then it is upon that individual to abandon chasing after the life of this world. Take that which you need, which will suffice you to get by, and put your focus and make your priority the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Out of what? Out of shyness for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever does that, وَمَنْ فَعَلَ ذَلَكَ فَقَدْ اسْتَحْيَى. And whoever has done that, then he has observed the true shyness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But some people, they lack shyness. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, وَالْحَيَا شُعْبَةٌ مِّنَ الْإِيمَانِ. Shyness is a branch of faith. So understand that whenever you lack shyness with Allah, you lack faith. There is a deficiency in the faith. Whenever there is a deficiency in the shyness, as Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu mentioned, إِذَا ذَهَبَ الْحَيَاءَ يَتْبَعُهُ الْإِيمَانِ أو كَمَا قَالُ. That whenever the shyness leaves, the person's faith follows right behind it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, إِنَّ مِمَّا أَدْرَكَ النَّاسُ مِنْ كَلَامِ النَّبُوَّةِ الْأُولَى إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاسْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ. Indeed, that which the people have reached from the speech of the first prophethood, that if you do not have any shyness, do as you wish. People misunderstand this narration. There are two meanings to this narration. Number one, it is a threat. A threat from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you're not afraid of Allah, go ahead and do as you wish and wait for the punishment of Allah to come to you. That's one meaning. The other meaning is the Prophet is informing us about a people who do not have shyness. When you find criminals indulging in evil, is because they lack the shyness in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't care how Allah sees them. They don't care what Allah hears them say. They don't care that Allah knows what's in their hearts. They have no shyness in front of Allah, so they do whatever they will. And then you have the righteous people, that they are not shy as it relates to doing an act of goodness. So the Prophet is telling the people of goodness, proceed upon that act of goodness, because there is no shyness when it comes to doing good. One of the Salaf, he was asked about al-muru'a. What is manhood? What is womanhood? فَقَالَ أَلَّا تَعْمَلْ فِي السِّرْ شَيْئًا تَسْتَحِي مِنْهُ فِي الْعَلَانِيَةِ. Don't do anything in secrecy that you are ashamed of doing in public. That's true manhood and womanhood in Islam. If you are ashamed of doing something in public, don't do it in the privacy of your home. Why? Because Allah is watching. And the believer is always mindful that Allah is watching. And that Allah, He hears everything and He knows everything. So Allah, He mentions, وَهُوَ مَعَهُمْ, and He's with them. And what is meant by Allah being with them? Meaning Allah is with them by way of His knowledge. Allah is with them by way of His sight and His hearing and being all aware. And not that Allah is everywhere in His essence. For the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never believed that Allah is everywhere. Nor did the Sahaba radiallahu anhum believe that Allah is everywhere. Allah Azza wa Jal, He said to Musa and Harun, إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَ أَسْمَعْ وَأَرَىٰ. Indeed, I am with you. I hear and I see. I hear and I see. Also, Allah Azza wa Jal, He mentions, Ar-Rahman ala al-Arsh istawa. The most merciful, He rose above the throne. And in the narration where Muawiyah ibn Hakim al-Sulami, he became angry and he smacked a servant girl of his, and afterwards he had regret. And the Prophet said to him, Itti biha, bring her to me. And then he said to her, Ain Allah, qalat fis sama, qala wa man ana, qalat anta Rasulullah. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اعتقها فإنها مؤمنة. The Prophet asked her, where is Allah? She said, Allah is above the heavens. She didn't say Allah is everywhere. Allah is above the heavens. If she was wrong, wallahi the Prophet would have corrected her right then and there. Where is Allah? في السماء. Allah is above the heavens. And he said to her, and who am I? She said, you are the messenger of Allah. The Prophet said to Muawiyah ibn Hakim al-Sulami, free her, for she indeed is a believer. Go back to the tafsir of قَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ قَوْلَ الَّتِي تُجَادِلُكَ فِي زَوْجِهَا. Allah has heard the speech of the woman who argues with you regarding her husband. Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي وَسِعَ سَمْعُهُ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. Blessed be Allah, whose hearing encompasses everything. And then she mentioned she was in the room with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the woman, and she couldn't hear everything that Allah, that the woman was saying. But Allah, who was above the heavens, He heard everything, and then He sent down the verse to the Prophet. It's important that we believe correctly. This is the part of having shyness for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that our belief and our understanding of Islam is correct. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, Inna lillahi tis'a wa tis'een isman, wa man ahsaha dakhala al-jannah. That indeed Allah, He has 99 names. Whoever memorizes them, he will enter into paradise. What is meant by memorizing them? Meaning that a person memorizes the name, he understands it correctly, and he lives his life in accordance to that. Allah is As-Samir, Allah is the all-hearing, so He's careful with His speech. Allah is Al-Basir, Allah is the all-seeing, so He's careful with His actions. Allah is Al-Khabir, the all-aware, He's careful with that which he does, because he knows Allah, he sees him, he hears him, he's aware. This is how the person observes the shyness and the mannerisms with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those who will memorize His name and His names and live their lives in accordance with Him and enter into the paradise. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those who preserve their heads and preserve their insides, their bellies, and stay away from the haram. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who truly desire the hereafter and do not chase after the life of this world at the expense of our deen. Aqulu qawli hadha, astaghfirullah li wa lakum, wa subhanaka allahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Aqim as-salah.